हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज बाय शेठ विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस एंड कॉमर्स। माई सेल्फ जयेश राजगोर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी 12th स्टैंडर्ड इकोनॉमिक्स न्यू सिलेबस चैप्टर नंबर 5 फॉर्म्स ऑफ मार्केट। यस माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर्म्स ऑफ मार्केट। We have already discussed a few concepts about this chapter in the previous video lectures. Today, we'll try and understand some more interesting types of market in today's video lecture. My dear students, as you know, market is generally understood as a particular place or locality where goods are sold and purchased. But in economics, market refers to an arrangement through which buyers and sellers come in close contact with each other directly or indirectly, and exchange of goods and services takes place among them. Yes, my dear students, it is very essential to understand that in a market, there has to be a product which has to have a particular price. Whereas buyers and sellers must come into contact with each other directly or indirectly. My dear students, if we go through the definition, according to Augustine Cournot, a famous economist, he termed market just as not a place, but economists understand the term market not any particular marketplace in which things are brought and sold, but the whole of any region in which buyers and sellers are in such a close contact with one another that the prices of same goods tend to equality easily and quickly. So it is not only about a particular place, but it is about the whole region where buyers and sellers are coming into close contact. My dear students, in the previous video lectures, we also saw the classification of market on the basis of place, time and competition. Yes, my dear students, we saw that on the basis of place, market is classified into three, that is local, national as well as international market. Local market is the one where the place of production and consumption is completely local, or we can say in a particular region itself. Similarly, the national level market is where the production, the export happens only in the boundaries of a particular country. Whereas international, as we all know, exports, imports, buying and selling goes across borders. Similarly, on the basis of time, classification is done as very short period, long period and very long period market. We also saw in the previous lectures about classification of market on the basis of competition. Yes, my dear students, this is the most important part of this chapter, where we saw perfect competition and imperfect competition. In perfect competition, we saw that everything seems to be very perfect. Laissez-faire policy is used, and somewhere or the other, everything is so perfect that there are a large number of buyers as well as sellers. But as we come across imperfect competition, we can see that imperfect competition is further divided into monopoly, oligopoly, and monopolistic competition. Let us have a look at some of the important points in detail. My dear students, on the basis of competition, in the previous video lectures, we studied about perfect competition. Perfect competition is an ideal and imaginary concept of market rather than an actual market. According to Mrs. Joan Robinson, perfect competition prevails when the demand for the output of each producer is perfectly elastic. This is a market which is an imaginary market. It doesn't prevail in reality. A perfectly competitive market is a one in which the number of buyers and sellers is very large. All the buyers and sellers are engaged in buying and selling a homogeneous product without any restrictions. Similarly, in the previous video lectures, my dear students, we also saw about price determination under perfect competition with the help of this diagram, which showed us how exactly equilibrium price is obtained when there is an intersection of demand and supply. Moving further, when we come on to imperfect competition, we saw about a specific type of market called as monopoly. Yes, my dear students, if you remember, the term monopoly is derived from the Greek word mono, which means single, and poly, which means seller. Thus, monopoly is a market in which there is only one seller who controls the entire market supply for a product which has no close substitute. So, this paragraph becomes very important, my dear students. Once again, I repeat, the term monopoly is derived from the Greek word mono, which means single, and poly, which means seller. Monopoly is a market in which there is only one seller who controls the entire market supply for a product which has no close substitute. So, today's topic of discussion is something which is different from monopoly. Yes, my dear students. Today, we need to understand the various types of monopoly prevailing. Yes, my dear students. As we saw, that monopoly means single seller. But we also need to understand how exactly monopoly is classified. So, let us try and understand types of monopoly, wherein the first type is private monopoly. Yes, my dear students. When an individual or private body controls a monopoly firm, it is known as private monopoly. Very simple to understand. When an individual or a private organization or a body controls a particular firm, it is known as private monopoly. For example, Tata Group, Birla Group, or we can say the Reliance Group. So, in this way, my dear students, you can understand what exactly private monopoly is. Moving on to the next type. The next type of monopoly here is public monopoly. As now we know, private monopoly is nothing but owned by private individuals, whereas public in economics means government. When the production is solely owned, controlled, and operated by the government, it is known as public monopoly. Yes, my dear students. It is usually welfare oriented. There is no profit oriented. This is not profit oriented completely. My dear students, public monopoly is government's monopoly. And the most common or prevalent example of this is Indian Railways. Yes, my dear students, the railway is completely monitored and completely run by the government with some stakes of private holders, but somewhere or the other, it is completely controlled by the government and thus it is public monopoly. Moving on to the next one, we have legal monopoly. Yes, my dear students, this monopoly emerges on account of legal provisions like patents, trademarks, copyrights, etc. Yes, my dear students, when you have made something original, you have gone for a music, or we can say a song, or a label, or a design, or a book, or you are an author of a particular book, you can approach the government bodies and ask for a trademark or a patent or a copyright for your work. The law forbids the potential competitors to imitate the design or form of the product registered under given branded names. So, your original work can be registered as a copyrighted material and no one else can use this. Such type of a monopoly is called as legal monopoly. For example, Amul products, they always have a branding of Amul on it. So, such monopoly is called as legal monopoly. Yes, my dear students, moving on to the next one, we have natural monopoly. The monopoly created on the basis of natural conditions like climate, rainfall, specific location, etc. is known as natural monopoly. Basically, my dear students, natural, the word itself tells us about the natural conditions or monopoly created on the basis of natural conditions like the climate in that particular region, the rainfall or any other specific location which creates a natural surrounding or a natural monopoly for the product, such as tea in Assam or we can say wheat from Punjab are biggest examples about natural monopoly. Moving on to the next one, we have point number 5 which says simple monopoly. In simple monopoly, seller or a firm charges a uniform price for its product to all the buyers. Yes, my dear students, it is monopoly where there is only single seller, but here the seller is not having any price discrimination. He is charging a uniform price, a single price to all his buyers. So it is simple monopoly. Moving on to the sixth type, it is discriminating monopoly. Now this comes to discrimination. In discriminating monopoly, firm charges different prices to different buyers for the same product. So in simple monopoly, uniform price. In discriminating monopoly, there is price discrimination. For example, a doctor charges different fees to different patients. So this is a part of discriminating monopoly. And now we move on to our last part, that is voluntary monopoly. Yes, my dear students, voluntarily, when a few firms, or we can say a few companies, go for mergers or collaborations, it is voluntary monopoly. To avoid cutthroat competition, some monopolists voluntarily come together and form a group of monopolists. This facilitates them to maximize the profit. For example, Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, that is the OPEC organization. And so this is a part of voluntary monopoly. So here, my dear students, today we complete types of monopoly, wherein we have private monopoly, public monopoly, we have legal monopoly, natural monopoly, simple monopoly, discriminating monopoly, and voluntary monopoly. So I hope this answer is clear to you all. We'll meet soon in the next video lecture with some more interesting answers. Till then, stay connected, stay safe. Thank you very much.